I think there's been a real anti-science, anti-technology movement in foods over the last decade. So I think a lot of people are saying, well, keep science away from our foods. But I think we really, really need it. You know, if we really, you know, seriously want to feed everybody in the world and reduce pollution, we need technological solutions, whether it's robots or artificial intelligence, nanotechnology, gene editing. I think we need to look at all of them, and we need to assess the risks and benefits of each of them and use the ones that make sense. It's one of the exciting things about being a food scientist. It's just such a really interesting, complex subject where you deal from like right down from the molecular level and trying to understand what's happening between two or three molecules, you know, right up to big social issues, you know, like how do we feed the world or how do we prevent chronic disease. In the developing world, there's still 800 million people starving. But in the developed world, we've got the opposite problem. We've got too much food and people are overeating. We've got obesity and diabetes are increasing. And there's lots of other diseases related to food. We can't keep eating meat the way we're eating now. It's put such a stress on the environment, so we have to find alternatives. Plant-based foods is one option. Another way is to use insects. You know, and there's already 2 billion people in the world routinely eat insects every day. Growing meat in a test tube is another very viable option. So I think we'll have a lot of different protein sources available to us in the future.